What's up? George from Filmora, here to empower your inner video creator. In my last video, I showed you how to use 3D LUTs as presets to make your footage look more cinematic. That's why in this video, I'm gonna give you a crash course on color grading. We're gonna teach you to color grade from this to this. We're gonna cover topics such as grading, color correction, and LUTs and presets. I'm gonna use Filmora, but the techniques I'm covering are pretty universal and can be applied to most softwares. However, if you wanna follow along, you can try Filmora free by clicking on the link in the description box below. Let's get started. For those who don't know, color correction is not the same as color grading. Color correction is the process of actually correcting your footage, such as fixing the white balance to make the whites truly look white, or fixing the exposure if the shot is too bright or dark. Color grading is the process of manipulating your footage to create other tones, emotions, or any other creative applications on your footage. When it comes to color correction and grading, it's good practice to first color correct your footage and then use color grading. So let's jump into Filmora and I'll show you the tools to color correct and then grade your footage. To make color adjustments to your footage, use the Advanced Color Tuning tool. Here you'll see tools to adjust your footage. But before we do our first correction, let's go into depth about some of these tools. Histogram. This top graph with the lines is called the histogram. A histogram is a graphical representation of the tonal values in your video. It shows the amount of tones of brightness found in your video ranging from black to white. Shadows are displayed on the left side of the histogram, and as you move to the right, this is where the highlights are displayed. The middle portion of the histogram represents midtones. The vertical axis displays the amount of tones of that particular lightness. White balance. The first tool you'll see when correcting your footage is the white balance tool. White balance is adjusted by two axes, temperature and tint. Temperature is the main one you'll be working with, and it adjusts colors from blue to orange. Tint is pretty much the same thing as temperature, but instead you work with green and purple. 3D LUT. This will apply a base of color grade to your footage. You usually don't apply this until after your color correction, and we actually have an in-depth video just on 3D LUTs you can check out by clicking on the card above. Exposure. This tool is for shifting your exposure. It's like changing the in-camera settings in post-production. Moving this slider either increases or decreases all of the elements that go into exposure at once. Brightness is commonly known as the slider that adjusts the midtones, but there's a little more to it. All the settings still change when utilizing the brightness slider, but it preserves the highlights better than simply dialing up the exposure, and it affects the midtones more nicely. The slider for contrast is pretty self-explanatory. It'll either add or reduce the amount of contrast in your image. The vibrance tool increases the intensity of the more muted colors and leaves the well-saturated colors alone. Using the vibrance tool is a good way to tone down saturation for skin tones. The saturation tool is a uniform way to increase or decrease the intensity of all colors in your shot. The highlights tool will affect the highlights, which are the brightest parts of your video. The shadows tool is pretty much the same as the highlights tool, except it influences the darkest areas known as the shadows. When it comes to tools that affect the blacks and whites, they are similar to highlights and shadows. However, whites affect the absolute brightest part of your image and blacks affect the absolute darkest. If you're wondering how these are different from highlights and shadows, it's that the highlights and shadows slider influences dark light or bright shadow areas, where whites and blacks directly affect the brightest and darkest points in an image. The HSL section is an acronym for Hue, Saturation, Luminance. This section is where you can make very accurate changes to specific colors in terms of its hue, saturation, and luminance. The last section in this workflow is the Vignette feature, which is where you can create the effect of having the corners of your image more dark or light. It's very likely that you'll not use all of these tools in a single clip. I usually use only about half or even less. But now since you know them, let's put some of them into practice. All right, so I have this cool clip of a monkey I'm gonna show you how to do advanced color tuning with. So first, you'll wanna open the advanced color tuning window by double clicking on the clip and selecting the advanced. Here, you'll wanna choose the frame that you wanna work off of so you can see all the colors in your clip. That's a pretty good frame to start from. And keep in mind the histogram up here. This graph will show you kind of where you're at with your color tuning. So for example, If I crank the exposure, it's gonna make the footage look a bit less quality. And you'll see in the histogram, it's gonna push the values up against the graph. You don't want that. So then take that back. And the first thing I noticed when trying to grade this footage and correct it is that the temperature is a bit blue. So I'm gonna turn it up, making it a bit warmer. The next thing I notice is that the greens are not vibrant enough. So in order to change any of your colors, you go down to HSL, choose the color, and turn up the saturation if you want it to be more vibrant, like in this case. See if it's really low, you can see the difference, and then when you bring it up, it's much more vibrant. All right, so that looks pretty good for a correction. The last thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna apply a 3D LUT. This is basically like color grading your footage. So let's look at some examples. Maybe not that one. Okay, the Star Wars one looks pretty cool. All right, let's use that one. Maybe I can adjust the temperature a bit more. All right, that looks good. There you go. So as you've seen, sometimes your LUT can be a bit overpowering. Don't be surprised if you have to do some adjustments to your color correction to get it perfect afterwards. All right, so you finished color grading your single clip with a LUT. But what if you have multiple tracks on your timeline? Then you'll have to repeat this process of coloring each clip individually. So I suggest playing around with the LUT, getting it right, and then saving your preset by clicking Save Preset. All right, well that's it for this quick crash course on color grading in Filmora. When used correctly, Filmora's color tool can be very powerful. Hope you found this tutorial helpful. I'm George from Filmora, here to empower your inner video creator. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. I'll see you next time. Ciao.